In this task, we will learn a little bit about build tools, in particular about makefiles, which are very primitive but yet very powerful. What we've seen in the first task is that when we needed to build a library or we wanted to compile multiple C files, we had to run GCC multiple times. Surely we could package this together in a shell script, but the problem would still be that every time we make a change in one of the files, we would have to recompile all the other files. So if builds get more complicated, and you can imagine to have a project that is huge, consisting of thousands of files, there exist specific tools that ease this process. One is the so-called makefiles. So to get started with the concept of makefile, what you need to do is you create a makefile, and this is literally the name. And this makefile contains a set of rules that are executed if the preconditions are met. So here's the typical format. So in this makefile, which is just a text file, we get a target, then we have a colon, and we can add a list of dependency files, and then we run a set of commands underneath. Here's an example. To build simple.exe, which is our target, so we want to have simple.exe, what we need to have as a dependency is simple.c and makefile. So if either of those files are changed, then simple.c gets rebuilt. And then here is the command, very simple command. We just run gcc and building it out of a simple c file. So let's have a look. So I prepared here simple.c, which is just a hello world program. And then I've copied this makefile. So it consists of just one rule. This is the only rule. Note that here is a tabular. That's very important. It's not a space. It's really a tabular, because that's the format understood by make. And now what we will do, we will have a look. There's nothing here in this directory. I run make. This command is an own program. It will look for a makefile, lowercase makefile like in this case, or an uppercase makefile. In this case, we have the lowercase version. And now it runs the rule. Let's have a look, simple.exe. Now it has been created. What happens if I run make again? It says, you know, this file is already current, so it's up to date. All right, so let me make a change now to this C file. Yeah, let's say hello world 2. Go back to our terminal, run make again. You see it's going to be updated. So that's really the purpose of make, is to have these rules, and these rules, they check if a file is newer, have been updated, if a dependency has been updated, has a newer timestamp compared to the target, then it needs to run the respective rule. You can have multiple rules. So I could have, for example, a rule where I say the rule is all called all. It's a typical rule, by the way, that you find in makefile. And then we say this rule requires simple.exe. Now the definition of simple.exe is found here, so we can use it this way. I can also say to build simple.exe, what you need is simple.o, and then we combine simple.o, and simple.o can be built out of simple.c. Run gcc simple.o at simple.c and create an object file with the dash c. Now let's have a look at this set of rules. Yeah, you can see the actual order doesn't matter much. So I could, you know, copy this code over here. It would still work. The only thing that matters is that the first rule is the default rule that typically gets executed. So when I run make, we can see it actually run all these rules. It run the first rule, simple.c, gets converted in simple.o, and then it run the second rule, and we find here simple.o and simple.exe. So that's very convenient. And if you want ever to build something specifically, let's say I remove simple.exe, and I can say make, and then I can specify the target like simple.o. Now it will just run all the rules that will lead to this specific target. Okay. A typical rule that we find often in a makefile is clean. So So with clean, we want to remove, for example, all our .old files, and we want to remove our .exe files. Yeah, so this really serves the purpose to clean up. If you want to have a clear build, let me run it. I can just say make clean, and you say all is gone. So I could also say make all, because all is a potential target. Okay, now that we understand a little bit about makefiles, what you should do is you should start with this example makefile here and basically formulate all the rules that we have learned about for task one to build a library, yeah, into this makefile format. And then as a result, you will get the library and you will get two test programs. Yeah, you will get the test one program and the use program. So what do you have to do? And here's an example given already, which contains part of those rules. Yeah, but they are not complete. So have your thought based on what you've learned. Good luck. And if you have any problem, talk to us as usual.